So, hello everyone. This is the third topic which we are covering, the logic app. And what is logic app? If anyone have any idea about logic app, just some words about the logic app. No. Okay, that's fine. So let's start here. Myself, Shadab, and I'm Microsoft Certified Trainer and Cloud Architect, having 14 years of experience. And what is Logic App? So just wanted to say that it's a similar kind of a stuff with the Azure function and the logic app. It's both are interrelated, both work together seamlessly without any issue, and it's having very good relationship between these two applications. Okay, both are serverless, both can be configured as serverless, and it can be scaled, it can be deployed. That can be done anywhere. So what is the Azure Logic App? It's like you can say that enterprise application integration tool. You can say a EAI tool, okay? So what this having, this gives a feature like you don't have to write a lot of code. Like in the function, you have seen that we have to write each and every line of code for our development purpose. But in this, it's a EI tool. It's a workflow based, okay, integration, which you can integrate with the any application, okay? Okay, so you can have a simple scenario, like I want to, I have a development VM, okay, which developers use, okay, daily basis. I have a VM which is created in Azure, and sometimes developers forgot to shut down the application, which incurs some cost for me. Okay, so what I will do, I will just create a logic app and say that just go and shut down those app, those VMs, which is tagged with the development at 6 p.m. daily. It's just a simple automation which you are doing with the logic app. Okay, so you can just go and create your logic app, and that can be done. So what is that? This is the automation workflow solution. No code designer, there is nothing like you can write code. Yeah, but if you want something to connect with your legacy application, okay, you say that I have a legacy application, and I have a logic app here. And we don't have any connector. Let's suppose that my logic app is not providing me any connector to connect with my legacy application, okay? That is written somewhere in the old style or something, okay? So you have a legacy application. Okay, so what do you have to do? You don't have directly direct connector here to connect with this application. So you have to write some custom coding. What you have to do? Logic App doesn't provide you custom coding. Okay, so you go write in the Azure function. Okay. Connect your logic app with Azure function, and then Azure function will talk to legacy application. So this Azure function is giving you a feature which you can write, customize your code, and you can connect with the legacy application. So here in the logic app, you have the designer base, and you can just go ahead and select those, and you just drag and drop some of the application, and it works fine. So you have workflow, you have triggers, you have action, and you have connectors. So these are the four or important thing which we will be always talking in the logic app. Okay. So what is workflow? Like it's a business step, like a step by step solution. If you heard about the, there is a component like software comes with the Microsoft that is called Microsoft BizTalk Server. That also an enterprise application, and that gives you features similar to the logic app. Okay, so that's on-prem. Okay, now that has to install some application and you have to use it. But here, that's the flavor. It's same thing is giving in your Azure. So you can write a workflow. You can have a step-by-step solution. Like I want to read some data, and after that, you want to give a send mail for the manager for approval. So that can be possible here. So you will, whatever you think, I want to create a workflow, you can create it here. Second thing, you have a trigger. Trigger is means what step, how our logic app will initiate. So you have a different type of trigger available. Next is action. What action you have to do after the trigger? And then you have the connector where you can again connect with a different set of application. So here is a workflow component. Okay, so you have trigger, you have actions, and then you have connector. So these are the workflow. These are the connectors available with the logic app. You have Facebook connector, you have Dropbox, you have Twitter. I want to see that if anyone is tweeting with hashtag anything with my company name. I want to read those content and send it to my particular email ID so that they can take action. Okay. So that's very much possible. You can read your Twitter handler with hashtag value, and then you can take an action on that. Okay. You have Service Bus connector, Trilia connector, HD Insight. There are so many connectors already available. You can see here the connector. We have a SharePoint connector, OneDrive, Dynamics CRM, Salesforce, and many more. Okay. Other thing that you can always write your custom connector as well. Like if you want to write some custom connector, so that also features available with the logic app. You can write your custom connector, which is not available. You can write your own code and then you can connect your connector. You can deploy your connector and then you can use it. Okay. Hybrid connectivity, it talks about the hybrid connectivity, like I want to connect my logic app to some on-premises gateway. So you will be having the hybrid connection manager installed in on-prem, and then your logic app will talk to that. So yesterday also I was talking about this hybrid connection manager. So I just have I updated this one. So you can refer this. I'll share this link as well with you. So whenever you want to connect your on-prem service with using the hybrid connection, what you have to do, you have the app service. This could be your logic app. This could be your app service. This could be your function app, anything. And you will be having hybrid connection manager, which is called hybrid connection relay, and which connects to the hybrid connection manager. Okay, so hybrid connection manager will be installed on-prem. And you have anything in the on-prem, like you have database, you have local payment gateway installed on your on-prem. You have, like here, you can see in the PPT, you have IBM, SAP, SharePoint, which is there in running in on-prem. So on-prem server, you will install a hybrid connection manager, and you configure their IP and port, which you want to expose. And then hybrid connection manager will connect to the hybrid connection relay will connect with the hybrid connection manager, and it works like that. So you can always use hybrid connection manager with logic app. Okay, so there are so many things which is available in the Azure, and then you have hybrid connection which connects with your on-premises gateway. Next is the enterprise integration pack. So this actually comes with logic app, where you can have your structure defined, like you can define your XML, you can define your mapping. So what happens, like, let's suppose that you are getting some different format from some other client. You want to change that format to different data form. So what you will be using, like, let's suppose that my client A is sending some data, okay, some XML data, okay. I want to change this in the JSON format. Okay, so what I have to do? I can use this enterprise application pack, and you can create a mapping document. You can define your structure. Okay, it supports actually ADI FACT, X12, AS2O. So those are the standards which we can use for our XML and JSON document, and we can connect with the different business to business scenario. Okay, so this gives you the enterprise integration pack. So you can see here enterprise integration steps, create an integration account. So you have to create an integration account in the Azure portal. And then you have the patterns, schema, certificates, map, and agreement will be installed inside the integration account. Okay, so you have the mapping, you have the certificates, like if you connect with the any third party like agency, and they gives you certificate to communicate with them. Either you have to attach the certificate while sending the data, or some data you are receiving with the certificate, which you have to validate. So that you can use with the enterprise integration steps. Okay, create a logic app, link with the your logic app with the integration account, and then it works like that. Okay, so also you can create your logic app with the Visual Studio. Okay, similarly, which we have seen in the function app, both way you can go and create on portal, you can go ahead and create in the Visual Studio. So both is available. Okay, here comes the logic app designer. Okay, we'll see in the demo, and that will be more clear. Okay, I'll move on to the portal. I'm just searching here, logic app. Add logic app. And then you select a resource group, enter your logic app name, test. Okay, so this is not unique across the globe. This is inside your application. Okay, we select region here. Log analytics. So this is the log analytics which help you to store logs and those things which you can use. And just create. Okay. Oh, let me go to the resource group then. Resource group. Just refreshing. Here is logic app, correct? Okay, I can open this logic app. First, it opens the designer part. Okay, you can always close here and you can go here. Okay, so there is nothing has been created. You can go to Logic App Designer. Okay, here is the Logic App Designer. I was talking about the Hybrid Connection Manager. You have the networking somewhere here, and that you can connect with the connections. Let's move to Logic App Designer. Okay, see here. This is the trigger. First is the trigger. What trigger you need to start this Logic App? You want to read the data from service bus. You want a HTTP hook. Like you can, if you're creating this, that would be giving the API endpoint and which you can use anywhere in your application. Another thing, you want to read a Twitter, you want to event grid, and there are so many. Like you want to read the even email, if an email is coming to some mailbox, that can be work. Okay. So these are the so many triggers are available. Okay. So I'll just take a blank Logic App now to start designing the workflow. Okay. So do you know about RSS feed? This is the RSS feed. Okay. Let's suppose I want to read any news which is getting published on the, you can see here. Generally, this news channel and other broadcasting, they use a feed, RSS feed, and they just post their news on the particular URL. So what you can do, I'm using this feed, okay, to read the news. Whenever it's getting posted, any news, I want to read the news and display in my website, or I want to send a mail to a particular person, okay? So that I can do it here, okay? So this is a simple integration we'll try here. Okay, so I'll take this URL and I'll use a RSS connector. So just I'll show you, if you talk about Azure, see, you have a Azure service connector, you have service bus connector, event bus, whatever you talk, if you talk about, I want to connect with SharePoint. We have connector for SharePoint, okay? We have connector for everything. Like I want to connect to Dynamics CRM. So whatever you name, you will be available here. Okay, I want to read whenever any Facebook post is done. Facebook. You have connector for that as well. Okay, so whenever you think that I want to connect to this application, come to Logic App, you have the connector ready here. If you don't have connector, again, you can go and create your custom connector. Okay. So you have the OneDrive, you have the other as well. So you can do that. So now I just wanted to see the if any message is getting published on RSS feed, I want to read that message and I want to send a mail. Okay, so it's simple. You can achieve the complex as well. So anything you can design here. Okay, I'll put the URL here. I'll just say every 1 minute I want to trigger this Logic App. Okay. Next. What I want to do, I want to send mail. I can use Gmail, I can use Outlook, I can use anything. You can use Gmail here. If you want to use Outlook, you can use Outlook. So there are multiple connectors. So this is the first one is your trigger. Next is action, what action you want. And you will be designing a workflow, okay? So I'll just write here, Gmail. Okay, what I want to do? I want to send a mail. Okay, so it's asking me to sign in. So my Logic App is creating a API connection with the Google. So will ask for login. Okay, I can take my one of the Gmail ID. Okay. I'm allowing my Azure Logic App to use my mail ID to send, read, or any whatever action it wants can be done. Okay, so here it's connected. Okay, so the mail will be sent from the mail ID which I have just logged in. So that mail ID will be from email ID. Okay, whom I want to send? I want to send to another mail ID, my Hotmail ID. Okay, what things you want to send? Okay, I want to send the subject and body. You can always add BCC, CC. So those are the here. Okay. This is my subject. You can put here like read title. Okay. Here is link of. You can put here primary feed link and just save. So this is the simple integration which we want to do. Okay, just if any feed is getting created here, okay, and then it triggers the mail. You can come here, refresh. You can always go ahead and disable this logic app if you want, and otherwise it will be keep on running. You can create click here to run manually as well. Okay, otherwise it will be keep on running always. It will be always going and checking there every 1 minute what is happening there. Okay. So if any feed they are posting in 1 minute or anything, that will be triggered here. Okay, so this is what it's saying. You can always go, even I'll just show you one more thing if you want to explore, like, if any approval flow you want to give, you can do that approval flow as well. Okay, like this, you have the approval from manager, approval mail ID you can send, and that action. Again, when you add the approval, like I want to send approval, then again, you have another action out of that, okay? So after this approval, what you want to do? You want to reject or approve. So there'll be another set of rules which you'll be doing. Okay. Let's suppose that if I want to create a next step, so again, my Gmail output will be available here. Okay. To update a data or anything you want to do. Okay. Let's see here. So always you will be having output from this two available for the third one. So whatever the connectors has been executed on above, you have the output from that connector available in the next step. So that you can use it and you can utilize that. See, from the Gmail again, it's returning body. So you have the connector ready message from the feed as well as from email. So you can use those to develop a next workflow. We have not uploaded anything. Okay, I'll show you which I have created. Okay, another thing which I want to show here, see that if you have created logic app, with logic app we have created RSS API connector and the Gmail. Okay, now I have created Outlook, that has been also okay. So what is this? This is actually a API connection from your logic app to Gmail. Okay, so you can always go ahead and edit your API connections and those things. So what is happening internally, it's creating a service call from your logic app to the Gmail or to RSS. So that is happening here. I'll just show you, I have created one logic app. It's doing the same thing. Reading the RSS feed and sending mail, okay? you can see here there are so many success here. Okay, if I go here, I can see what happened to my logic app. Okay, so it's reading the RSS feed. This was the news has been published, and it's sending me the email at latest 31 state set to the one day coronavirus case or anything. So, do we have Gmail open here? Yeah, it's getting bombarded to my mail ID. So I use this from email ID for that, and it's sending me the here. If I click here, it's taking me to the same thing. Okay. So the whatever you can see here, RSS feed, it has been executed. So all has been came. You can see here failure. If it's something is running here, you can just go and right click and terminate. Everything you can do here in the Logic App. So it's very simple to design a workflow in Logic App. The same thing it's telling here about the RSS feed. Okay, you can schedule as well. So like if I want to create a new, if I want to go to Logic App Designer, just go ahead, delete. HTTP request, when HTTP request is received. Okay, let's see what happens. When you save, it is giving me a URL, which is nothing. It's a web app, like you can post the message on this URL. Okay, so it's giving you the features, and you can also define what JSON structure you are expecting. Okay, you are expecting some JSON structure, and that you can define. And then based on this action, once the someone is calling this URL, what action you need. So again, you want to update this document to blob or any other environment. So that action again, you have to write. So it's very simple. Just go ahead and use the connector, whichever you want, and just deploy those. So you can always schedule connector, and there are some recurrence connector, what time you want to start, what time you want to end. Okay, so all those features, see, this is the JSON structure is getting generated. So its URI will be generated. When you save that, you will get a new URL, and then when HTTP request is received, you are delaying for some time, and then you are doing some operation. Again, the feature is given here, the custom connector. You can always write your custom connector to connect to any another application. Okay, another thing which I Visual Studio. Again, you have a logic app here similar to the function. Okay. So again, that also gives you the feature where you can actually develop these workflow inside your Visual Studio, and then you can deploy. That's possible. And these are some PowerShell template. Actually, this document I'll share. Just go through this, because sometimes what happens in examination, they gives you the steps. And some wrong steps and correct step, and you need to find, or sometimes you need to arrange these. They will give in the drop down what it will come here. Okay, so just you have to select API connection or some other connection name they will give. So you might need to have a question around this as well. So these all templates is important for the examination and all. This is what was logic app. Any question around this, if you have.
Yes, Shadab. Where can we host these logic apps? Can you host it in app service plan, or can we make this as a serverless?
See, when we created a logic app, didn't ask anything. See.
Yes, it didn't ask anything, but
So this is completely serverless. You don't have option to select app service plan here.
okay, how do we monitor the cost then? Cost of the logic apps?
Cost will be basically its execution base and time base, how long it is running. You can go to just
Calculator, Azure calculator, something like that.
yeah, logic app pricing. Asia Pacific. Can go to Indian rupees. See, pricing is based on action. Price per execution. This is the action, a standard connector, enterprise connector. Like I showed you that we can have that enterprise connector as well. Okay, so this is for the developer. This is for premium. So these are the which is used. Like if you are using map, if you are using a schema. Okay, so enterprise account as well getting charged. Okay, enterprise account, I just, if I have time, I'll show you here. I was talking about enterprise account. So this is the enterprise account.
Okay.
Okay, if I go here and create enterprise account, what feature it gives you? STS, pricing tier free, basic standard. Okay, I'll take a standard one. I don't want log analytics next. So this is basically enterprise account I'm creating. So the logic app is not, it's giving me the workflow and it's enterprise application tool. But let's suppose that I want to connect with the different organization, which gives me a different structure. Again, I need to parse, and again, I have to choose for the some application and like mapping kind of thing, which you want to convert your one data to another data. Okay, generally it happens in healthcare, like they send some different structure. Okay,
Yes.
so you have the schema here. Okay, so a schema is nothing, it's a structure of document, you know that. So a schema will be there in the database as well, and XML, JSON, everything you have. So you can define a schema, you can define map, like you can change from the one to another. Okay, another to like maybe in enterprise application, you are getting one structure and then you are putting it to different format and sending it to database. Again, you are getting some value from database, which you have to map it to the original XML and send it to the customer. So that you can do it here.
Okay.
This is the external assembly as well. Like you have done some .NET coding external, which is not used inside, you can use those. This is the certificates, which is the important part to connect with the client and the different company partners. Similarly, you can define the different partner which you are dealing with. So these are the some of the enterprise capability which you are using, and this you can link with the logic app. Okay,
Oh.
you have enterprise application connector in the logic app, which help you to connect with this and you pass the your value and get the result out of that. Like it will be like you just create your logic app, you call this and you pass your value, you get the value. Okay, like that it will be happening.
Okay.
So this another one feature which she talks about.
Nice. Yep. And according to you, which one is most used in industry? Logic apps or function?
See, function, it's a you can say that it's a small kind job kind of thing. But here, what you are doing, you are completely creating a workflow, like end-to-end process you are doing. Okay, like I want to receive a mail, I want to do approval, I want to insert in database, I want to do another activity. Yeah, okay. So here your function app will help you somehow to get the required thing done in the logic app. Like if you just want to call a database and fetch the value, you can write a small code and that can be done. So like out of box, if you want to do, use the function app inside the logic app, it works seamlessly.
Correct. Yeah, I agree. Yeah, thanks, Shada.
Any other question? I'll share some of the link with you guys for the labs. Okay. Okay. Oh, we have time, then we can discuss some of the things here. See, there are some design patterns which you can go through that, okay, when you have time, like the cloud design pattern which Microsoft recommends you. So these are the things which is there. Again, there's a microservices architecture. We just spoke about microservices. It's very good to go through the microservice architecture. See, this is the serverless microservice architecture which is there. So if you go through this designing, so here we are using function, logic app, we are passing through the event grid, and then based on that event, there are some trigger is happening. Actually, these, if you see that Microsoft has not created like that, okay, there are some customer scenario problems and that has been taken care with these solutions. Okay, so it's very good architecture actually. So go through those architecture which will help you to develop your skill. And not being a developer, but when you are going for the next level architecture background on those things, so you might have to design this kind of thing. So start building those things towards the Azure, and you might have so many things. Okay. Again, this is the one architecture is showing. Okay. So just go read those documentation from the Microsoft and try to cover those. Coming to the lab, there's two labs which we have discussed today. Okay. One for the function. Just go ahead and try to replicate this. It's the step-by-step process. There's nothing much. If we have anything, we can discuss it later or under class. One for logic app, one for function app. Okay. Generally, if you cover those, it will be very good because you will be having question around this as well. Okay. So what will happen, they might give you some specific scenario that from this lab, and you'll be having some scenario based question from the lab. So around 15% question, you can cover it with this, with the lab, in the exam. So I do. So for the preparation for the examination, you must do all this activity. Another thing, I'll share this PPT with you. And we have another, I found there's one developer guide for the Azure, what all topics you must cover being a developer and what all topics you should learn. So this is a very good guide you might be having, or I'll share with you all. You can go through this as well sometime. This tells the topic, what topics you should cover. Any question for the today's session? If you have any feedback, I might have gone fast or slow. Hope you have understand the things properly.
It is good to me, Shatav.
Good. good to hear. Thank you.
Yeah, it was good, Shada, but nothing from my end that I faced an issue or something.
That's fine. So just try to do whatever I have did and just try to understand the things.
One quick question, Shadab.
Yes.
For our practice, is Sandbox enough or do we need to buy the subscription from Azure?
Why to buy subscription? You can create,
you can
go ahead and create a free account with them, correct?
Yeah, but there is a 1 month limitation, is there, right? Yeah. So after 1 month, we cannot use it. So we'll have to make a pay as you go.
Nothing like that. You can use another email ID and create another trial version. Because practice, you don't have to think about that much.
Okay. Can we use the same credit card for the next email ID?
That works. If that is having problem, just let me know. I'll give you another option. Okay. Mm-hmm. What I have, if you are not able to create, there is called Azure Pass.
Okay.
Okay. This is no credit card required, and there is a code which I need to generate and give it to you. There is a redemption process. I'll give you the code and then you can follow. Again, it gives you same thing, 1 month trial. Okay. It doesn't require credit card. Okay. So you should have one coupon code which will be provided. And that coupon code you have to put. But again, that should be a new email ID and then that coupon code you will provide. But generally this you get it in the classroom training sometime with the sponsors who is giving the classroom training. They generally get from the Microsoft and give it to you during the training. Yeah.
Okay.
But just try with the free account. If you're not able to do, I'll help you on this.
Sure. Thanks a lot, Chadab. Yeah.
Okay.